nalingio Congo. Banyokolio Bokana Piso.
Let's talk Congo. Let's talk about Congo, my country.
Democratic Republic of Congo, my country.
Banyamulenge. Who are the Banyamulenge people? Are they Congolese? Are they Rwandese? Are they Burundians? Who are they? So I thought I should go on Wikipedia and just kind of find out who they are, because obviously, you know, there's been a dispute around their origins and who they are by nature. As you can see on the page there, it kind of clearly states that, you know, they migrated from Rwanda. So in essence, they are Rwandese. They migrated into North Kivu, and they are from the Tutsi tribe. And the Banyamulenge people speak Kinyamulenge, which is a mixture of Kinyarwanda and Kirundi. Obviously, Kinyarwanda is from Rwanda and Kirundi is from Burundi, which are their own country in essence. Now, there's been an issue going on around, you know, the killing of the Banyamulenge in South Kivu and so forth. But one of the issues that actually is coming, the fact that the Banyamulenge people are trying to capture Minembwe and make Minembwe into a sort of a country within a country environment, you know, a bit like the Vatican City, where you have the Vatican have their own, you know, authority, their own police and their own, you know, their own traditions and so forth. So they're not really looking to be part of the, let's say, the Congolese culture. You know, the Banyamulenge people, they do not mix with the Congolese people when they actually come to Congo. They do not mix cultures, they do not mix with Congolese traditions. They want to enforce their own culture onto Congolese people. Now, I'm all for sharing cultures, I'm all for sharing ideas and, you know, bettering a country or bettering a place. But this is not the case in the case of the Banyamulenge people. You know, obviously there's a lot of cries of the Banyamulenge being killed. But there's two sides to every story, and obviously I'm here to tell some or the other side of it. I'm sure you've heard of the term of Mai Mai people. You know, the Mai Mai are the local people who... I'll do a little bit of clip on the Mai Mai and give you a bit more information on what does, you know, Wikipedia says about the Mai Mai people, and, you know, also speak to my contacts and, you know, get a bit more knowledge around the Mai Mai. And myself, I'm from the Bembe tribe, which most of them are Mai Mai people, and I have stories about when I was younger about the Mai Mai people and how they protected the locals in that, you know, in that region. So I am a very proud Congolese, I am a very proud Bembe person, I am very proud of my origins, and I'm very proud of my experience in life. So as obviously I'm talking, you can see on the pages there's a lot of information going through around the Banyamulenge people and how they migrated into Congo, and how they started having political influence and so forth. So my thing is with the entire issue, with the Banyamulenge issue, is if you're going to come to someone's country, come, enjoy, be part of the culture, be part of the environment, be part of everything Congolese. Embrace the Congolese experience. Embrace it all. Above all, contribute to the country. On one hand, they're mourning the loss of the people that have been killed, but yet Congo has lost 6 million people. They do not make campaign videos about the people that are getting killed in Congo. Because you know what? Yes, Banyamulenge life is more important than the Congolese life. 6 million and counting died. You will not find a single YouTube video of Banyamulenge criticizing the death of the 6 million Congolese, because they are not important to the Banyamulenge people. Yeah, so I am not violence, and I'm not advocating for anyone to commit any violence against anyone. Because, you know, we in the world, we're going to be around here in this planet Earth, on this planet Earth for about 100 years, 120 years, if we're lucky. So violence is not really a solution to anything. In fact, it terminates the longevity of your existence on this planet. But I'm just questioning the whole narrative around Banyamulenge being the victims. Think about this. In Rwanda, there was a genocide. Who were the people involved? Hutus and Tutsis. Even though the narrative tend to be largely biased to one side, you know, the victors get to write the history, they say. Fast forward into Congo. 6 million people have died. Another genocide. What is a common thread? Well,
Wikipedia says about the Banyamulenge people and who they are, where they come from. Obviously, as I've mentioned already, they are of Rwanda origin. They are Rwandese by rights, and also according to the Rwandan constitution, anyone who's of Rwandan origin is by nature Rwandese. They haven't been neutralized, you know, because the constitution of Congo does not allow you to have two nationalities. You know, they haven't received the Congolese nationality, and they haven't, you know, and they're still under the Rwandan constitution. So it's a catch-22, and it's a case of where you have these the Rwandan president Kagame, who whenever there's any issue to do with Banyamulenge, he is always of an opinion. He always offers his opinion, because by essence these people are Rwandan by nature. You know, and obviously, on the other hand, when the 6 million plus Congolese have died, he has not offered any sort of opinion on this matter.
Alicia,